Hungered and ye gave me meat, I was thirsty and ye gave me drink, I was a stranger and ye took me in, naked and ye clothed me, I was sick and ye visited me, I was in prison and ye came unto me. So our ward, we had a food drive and we wanted to have like Thanksgiving meals for like families in the ward, and we wanted to have like 6 meals, but we ended up with 25. It's just crazy to think like how much support we have in this ward and like how many people donated. I felt like happy because like just to know that I was helping someone.
Each class chose a park that we went to, and we just got a bunch of water bottles, and we would walk around and hand out the water bottles, like, do you want some water? At the end of this activity, we all got back together, and we talked about how Christ is the living water for others and for everyone. Even though some said no, it was still good, just because it's like that missionary experience for us, and just kind of lets them know we love them.
And so within the young women in our ward, we wanted to get to know someone that maybe we didn't know very well, even better. So we were sitting by someone new and just talking to people we don't normally talk to. And so Alyssa somehow ended up with my name in the Secret Sister thing, and she was just awesome.
So I got Libby and I made a whole survey for her and brought her cookies.
So I wrote her just a note back, and it was just a really good thing just to get to know her better too.
I love that activity.
At first, he just was walking past my house. We're like, hey, what's your name? And like, we say hi to him. And then from now, we just wave at him when we walk home or if we see him at school.
It makes us feel really good. It's kind of making a new friend for us too.
And so our leader challenged us to go and find a stranger and take them in. There's this kid who kind of seemed stuck up a little bit, but I thought to myself, I was like, okay, I'll just try and get to know him, see what's really up with him. And usually I don't just like go and do that with people, but then as I got to know him, we became friends. Like, I noticed that he really needed a friend at that time, and we became pretty close, and he was able to tell me something that he was really struggling with. And I was able to help him and like get help for him. And it just made me think that Christ really like prompts us to do things, and we need to follow those promptings, because if I wasn't there following that in that specific time, I don't know where he would be right now. And I was able to help him.
We went around to all the neighborhoods and got the clothings from off their porches and then drove them back to our ward, and we split them up. The leaders encouraged us to go through our closets and find clothes that we no longer needed. After that, we took them to places that they could be sent to those in need. We had a lot of clothes. We filled up that gym. I felt very good doing it, and I knew that I was helping people in need.
We accepted the challenge to go visit the sick, and instead of actually like going and visiting them and like talking to them, we decided to make a sunshine box, and it had like things that were yellow in it, a yellow harmonica, and there was candy and cereal and stuff like that in there, just like to just brighten up their day. When I help other people, it makes me feel really good inside, and it helps me throughout the day, and it feels like I was helped, like personally, like, and spiritually.
In the Laurel class, we went and visited the sick. We visited some homebound elderly people in our ward, and we took them a treat and visited with them. She said she loved it, and just being able to talk to us.
As we had class, we were challenged to visit the sick. It was really fun, and it made me really emotional when we went there. It just felt awesome because we helped so many people. It makes you feel good, and it makes you want to do more.
My favorite activity was probably going to the nursing home and performing musical pieces for the people living there. It made the people in the nursing home feel happy, and like when we sing the song, some of them were singing along, and some of them asked for certain songs that they wanted us to sing. It was really cool.
So the people on the other side of the veil are in prison because they can't get to spiritual paradise unless they have been baptized. So we need to be baptized for them.
We went to the temple and we did family names to set the family free from prison. I brought 5 names from my family.
I hadn't been to the temple for a really long time, so when I went, it was really overwhelming, and then bringing my own names, I felt like they were there. Like they were able to witness it and that they were so grateful for it.
I love indexing. I think it's really fun. It makes me feel really close to the people that are on the records. So our goal was to index 3,000 names and set 3,000 prisoners free from spirit prison. Yeah, so I indexed 1,600 names.
I've never done all these projects in a row. It made me feel that I was doing the right thing.
I know, I think it's kind of a core part of our religion is to kind of serve our neighbors.
You can really see how it helps people and how it blesses everyone's lives.
For me to be a tool in God's hand in that way, it was really a powerful experience for me, because sometimes I feel like we just go throughout our days not really knowing what's going to happen and just kind of going and doing our own thing, but to notice that like we can really have an impact on someone like that in ways that we may not know, but we just really need to be paying attention and be focused on what Christ wants us to do.
Where we're serving time after time and where we're just continually doing service for a couple months, it kind of helps us to put it into our daily lives.
It kind of gets us in like a mood to help and do service all the time.
Well, because we're doing service towards other people who are also God's children, and we're God's children, and so when you do service, you're helping others, and that's what Heavenly Father wants.
And the king shall answer and say unto him, Verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of thee, my brethren, ye have done it unto me.